Hi, and welcome to Poetryspective number 58, our seventh online edition, sponsored by Pride of Our Footscray Community Bar, and brought to you here from the House of Schketz. My name is Lish, your MC for the evening. We have a really exciting night for you tonight with our two features and, of course, our open section, but especially our two features. Steve Smart, who shall be reading his own poetry. And, of course, he has been writing an hour-long show during isolation. And I know that he will be doing some of that for us with costumes and makeup. So it's going to be very, very cool and funky and, well, very Steve. And of course we have Colin Clark, our supreme video editor, maker, co-conspirator at Poetryspective, and he will be giving a retrospective of Adam Gibson, and there will be music and there shall be mirth and it will be wonderful. And then of course the open section, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. As many of you will know from attending Poetryspective, it is a tradition to recite two poems from our retrospective feature to open the open section with. And tonight I have chosen two poems from Colin Clark, the first being a villanelle called Villanelle for Villanelle. For all the death you cause, you do not grieve. The one who hunts you, known to you so well. You love her, but will you be killing Eve? Just like a ghost, you strike and then you leave, and languish in your own eternal hell. For all the death you cause, you do not grieve. She corners you, but offers you reprieve. Toys with your heart, sweet psycho villanelle. For all the death you cause, you do not grieve. With fine disguise, your prey you do deceive, and so you sound their final tolling bell. For all the death you cause, you do not grieve. You hear the final gasps your victims breathe, not even slight remorse you have to quell. You love her, but will you be killing Eve? In true beguiling love you do believe, head over heels for her you truly fell. For all the death you cause, you do not grieve. You love her, but will you be killing Eve? And the second poem that I've chosen, written by Colin Clark, is called The Caravan. A flood of humanity, the march of the penguins, no king or emperors here, everyone a little blue. Some are just searching for a bed, others a new home, a new life, children separated from families and reunited. The path is clear but twisting, with mythical shortcuts missed, no turning back allowed. We trudge ever onward. We finally arrive, tired and relieved, and then realise we've forgotten why the fuck we actually came to IKEA in the first place.
Why? I argue vehemently with others. And I think it's because it's the way I do it with myself. If I don't ask hard questions, I don't answer stupid fucking questions. I'm not brutal. I don't nag the fuck out of myself. I'll just wait myself out. So I'm rude and persistent. It's difficult for an actor to be dishonest. to her character. Essential to a magician to be dishonest to the audience. Somewhere in between is where politicians reside, and the essential difference is empathy. One feels what the audience feels, and the other thinks what the audience might believe, And the best actresses feel and emote that feeling. So are you feeling then?
Who's that, huh?
Basketballs, you're on fire. Can you make kebabs with that? Burn, baby, burn. Hey, it's monkey magic with fire. Do you serve pizza? You're hot, smoking. You've done martial arts. It's the fire fairy. Look, the fire dancer is back. Do you breathe fire? Light me up, baby. Keep being that dragon woman. Bless me with your flame staff. Light my cigarette. Light my cigar. Light my fire. You're blazing. Wow. Flaming amazing. I could do that. Can I have a go? I'll pay you $20. Come on. Fucking hippie. She's not wearing shoes. Don't burn yourself. Did you get kicked out of the circus? Do you take weed as payment instead of money? You're cooking and flaming good looking. How do you keep your stick lit in the rain? Fire magician on a mission. You're insane. You're so talented. You're dangerous. I want to be the fire dancer.
Hi everyone, I'm just going to do one poem and it's untitled and the theme is fragmentation around COVID-19. Air ripe with dewy petrichor, post-rain afternoon. A walk in the park, dogs sniff each other's bottoms, decide on friendship. Chattering children run around high on sugar, stumble and trip, clutch mummy's legs, whining and whinging, crocodile tears. Cutlery clattering as the table is set, frozen pizza in the oven, TV blaring, numbers rising, testing and tracing, clusters and curves, active cases, passive carriers, math exercise online, crayon smears on hallway walls, readers ripped in angst. Down the road, locked facility doors, masks and gloves, walking frames wiped every hour. A companion dog whimpers, urinates on the parquetry floor. A grandmother hallucinates, pulls at the tube, argues alone, screams to go home. Full moon, a midnight blue. Thank you. See you soon. Bye, Lish.
we now come to our first retrospective of the eve. Colin Clark, automotive engineer by day, poet by night, movie maker at weekends, is the executive producer, director, audio engineer, key grip runner, gaffer, best boy, worst boy, very naughty boy, and caretaker of our Poetryspective video presentations. And doesn't he do a great job? Yeah, he does. He burst quietly onto the Melbourne poetry scene in 2019. His work ranges across poetic genres, but is usually characterised by warped sense of humour and the love of a dark twist. When he sees a line in the sand, he smooths it out, draws a new one, and then crosses it anyway, just for fun. In late 2019, Colin emceed the highly successful Lish Skec testimonial, and he was also a finalist at Poetryspective Retro Slam, performing his take on the chap hop of Professor Elemental, and reprised the performance in the Pride of Our Footscray Christmas Panto. He performed a retrospective set earlier in the year with his musical collaborator Brendan Andersen. I believe he is back. I certainly hope so. Brendan Andersen is a really, really good guitarist, actually. You will hear. And earlier in the year, that's right, showcasing the work of Adam Gibson, and regularly hits the stage at the Poetryspective open mic. This is very true. He's been coming for a very long time now, and we are very fortunate that Colin came in to the venue and happened upon our poetry gig, because he has been an amazing supporter, and I'm so happy that he has joined the team. So Colin is available for gigs, children's parties, weddings, bar mitzvahs, and funerals, but he's never been invited back. So sit back, relax, and enjoy Colin Clark reciting Adam Gibson.
In 1980, when my sister was 19, she found an old car with the keys in the ignition near the bank of the estuary. She was 19 too when she left here altogether. She never came back. In the winter of 1984, an East Coast low pressure system destroyed the fleet in their moorings, smashed the jetty, and flattened half the town in a hailstorm the Weather Bureau somehow failed to mention might happen. The beaches on either side of the inlet disappeared in one day, and the rocks of the breakwater became cliffs overnight. It was that night that she called from somewhere down the coast, said a wobbegong shark had been washed into her local swimming pool at the height of the storm. "What do we do?" she said. "Get a blanket," I said. "What for?" she said. "Get a blanket," I said. "And pick it up like that. Just pick it up like that." On the eyewitness news of the world that night, I saw my sister with a blue-eyed man holding the edges of a dark and wet blanket, and they were hauling a shark out of a pool. And it gasped for air before they dropped it back into the sea. And it swam away very quickly. Swam away very quickly.
Good evening, and thanks everyone for joining us again in this seventh episode of our online Poetryspective. Recording here on a very wet, miserable Sunday night. So this is my, actually it's the third time I've done my Adam Gibson retrospective, once previously at Poetryspective and once at another event out in the country. Just a bit of background on Adam. So Adam's a musician and spoken word performer. He's based in Sydney, most well known for performing with his bands The Aerial Maps and more recently The Arc Birds. He's got two or three albums out, and in fact he's actually got a best of album out that came out just a week or so ago. If you like what you're hearing, very thoroughly recommend you check him out. I think he's excellent. The In the Blinding Sunlight album is really great, and there's some other two or three other really great albums as well. I'll put some notes in the description below, and notes to where you can check out Adam's work. Also want to thank my wonderful friend and great guitarist, as Lish said, Brendan Andersen, who's provided the guitar accompaniments on the works I'm performing tonight. Also, I've taken a little bit of a liberty. Adam's not averse to a bit of improvisation in his live shows. So I've kind of taken a bit of a liberty with a couple of the tracks, and maybe personalised one of them a little bit. In the track that you'll hear in a minute called As Good As, I've kind of added a second verse, which was more personal, sort of based off the things that I think my lovely partner is as good as. I'll stop talking now and let you get back to the works.
And it's the great silence here, playing all night through our sleep. And it's a great silent night. And it's been here all our lives. And it's a quiet Australian night, through Broadway and the rest. My brother and I keep driving towards the sunset, heading west. And it's the great silence here. It's the Featherfoots and the ghosts. And it's the amply melting roads. And the eventual western coast. Past Broken Hill and Pimba and the salt pans, heading west in the great Australian silence. And it's the great silence here. Playing all night through our sleep. And it's the great silent night of Australia and all our lives. On through Broadway, and we are heading west and all the rest. Of the Featherfoots and the ghosts, and the amply melting roads. How do you think it feels? How do you think it feels?
swung out to the edge of the reef, cuts across the skin. The salt plains west of Pimba. I don't know where to begin. The great Australian silence. The great Australian silence. And I'll dip my toe in Cottesloe and barefoot in the heat. How do you think it feels? How do you think it feels? There's the sound of my wheels. And the great Australian silence. And the same Australian heat. The great Australian silence. And the same Australian heat. Australian silence. And the same Australian heat.
You're as good as hot Milo on a July night. You're as good as a sneeze. You're as good as the click in your ears when you yawn. You're as good as the smell of chlorine, better than petrol. As unbelievable as the fact that my mum's cats remember me. You're as good as a beer in a tiled pub after 10 hours on the highway. You're as good as the hard soles of feet after 6 months of summer. You're better than Guinness, better than Spain. You're as good as sleeping, as incredible as the silence of the sea. You're as good as a chop top at the movies, as good as the ends of newly cut hair, as good as Oscar and Lucinda. As good as bliss. You're as good as Jim Beam. As good as place without a postcard. Better than diesel and dust. You're as good as a pie from the Woodburn cake shop. You're as good as a Neenish tart. You're that good. You're as good as fish and chips on the pier. You're as good as cricket. You're as good as a premiership after a 52-year drought. You're as good as a misty autumn morning. Better than summer. As unbelievable as the fact that we have kookaburras in our garden. You're as good as a cappuccino in a garden cafe on a beautiful Sunday morning. You're as good as the smell in the air after a thunderstorm. You're better than Scrabble. Better than birdsong, You're as good as a day off work. As incredible as Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. You're as good as a pie from the Flower Power food truck. As good as a newly sharpened chainsaw. As good as the night circus. As good as the castle. You're as good as Malbec. As good as in the blinding sunlight. Better than Dark Side of the Moon. You're as good as the Melbourne Comedy Festival. You're as good as macadamia shortbread. You're that good.
Some other dream I had. What did it involve? It's some other highway and some other car. Some other season, some other person, some other reason. Some other silence, some other collection of towns to be passed through, passed by, passed to. God knows we're in it, up to our eyeballs. Some other dream, some other city, some other specific night and the quality of light. It's a pale light in European winter, break your heart and break your head. Dreams and memories of moments, because I remember everything, I remember everything. Some other dream light, the long days of June and July, on the west coast of Scotland, the Isles of Skye, Iona. A specific night, washed hair with beer, a cigarette shirt, days of wine feet and coffee eyes, up to our eyeballs. Some other dream of some other city, some other specific night and the quality of light. Some other country, some other summer, some other lover, empty water, a wave on a beach and a silent night. The Fremantle sunset, or the back end of a bar stay, or a place without a postcode, of northern lights, forgotten, southern stars blurred. A dream we lean towards, touching all the way to the oncoming day. It's a koala spring evening, stare out to sea and see the ships at night, or some specific dream. A feeling of towns and unlocked gates. Laughing at the languages and speaking another tongue. Just because we can, because we feel like it, just because you want to. Some other specific dream of some other city, some other night, the quality of light. Semesters of hope. I've taken a bachelor's degree in non-bachelorhood, an undergrad's diploma in kissing and being kissed. I've just done a master's in unbelievability. And some other dream I have, what did that involve? A sky of absolute perfection, the perfect sandwich, the perfect beer, chilled glass. Lake Tahoe, or Glasgow, or that time in Hoi An. I've done it all, I've none regret. I've no reason, no silence of the night. Laughing and arguments, each fueled by the other. Undecided the explosion of swearing, of some other dream I had. Extremes and their B-sides, the moment between sleeping and waking, dreaming and knowing, that's what we'll get, that's where we'll take it, because I remember everything. I remember Alaska in 2018. The temperature was indeed minus 30 degrees. It out in the snow, that was a long way from some other dream I had, some other specific sense of night, some other city, some other town, and the quality of light. That's good enough for me. That's good enough for me. And I'll take it. I remember everything. I remember everything. Thank you.
pass over the land, and my eyes pass over the sky beyond the clouds. I pass my soul up to the heavens above, and it passes on, reaching towards infinity. There is no time in eternity, but no time waits for me on earth. My heartbeat charts the time. Its rhythm is my journey. My soul is not bound by earthly ties. Surely it is bound to find its own destiny. Break down the boundaries of life and create your own cycle. Let there be light when darkness falls. Do not take its brightness lightly. Along the dark path of life, there is always moonlight to guide you. Remember that light and shadow are twins. Make every footstep significant and tread your pathway freely. Life may pass, but the soul will never pass away.
Introverted extrovert of Gen X, meh. I've been waiting for this, baited. Ever since the hole in the ozone, it's fixed now. And hydrofluorocarbons, it's fixed now. And climate change, it's... Oh, wait. Sorry, but we had it then too. My windows to the world have been cathode, liquid and diode. Chasing ghosts, flying through space, building cities, saving the princess, going for that flawless victory. It's okay. You can do the voice. Now, you can see and hear your friends, family, and strangers from half a world away in high definition, surround virtual but are actually people, and sometimes it gets pixelated and the sound drops out, and turn the camera on for God's sake. Reality. Now, more disconnected than before. Now, more access to misinformation than before. Now, there's just more. I can hear the outside, so I know it's there. I just, like a mirror in a comic book about a maniac, it always seems better on the other side. Not now, though. Now it'll kill you. It'll get inside, invisible, with intent to harm. But we are all in this together, and in that, we are not alone.
Hi, this is from a book of poetry called Little Johnny's Confession, by Brian Patton. He's an English poet and he was born in Liverpool in 1946. And this one is called Prose Poem Towards a Definition of Itself. When in public, poetry should take off its clothes and wave to the nearest person in sight. It should be seen in the company of thieves and lovers rather than that of journalists and publishers. On citing mathematicians, it should unhook the algebra from their minds and replace it with poetry. On citing poets, it should unhook poetry from the minds and replace it with algebra. It should touch those people who despise being touched. It should fall in love with children and woo them with fairy tales. It should wait on the landing for 2 years for its mates to come home, then go outside and find them all dead. When the electricity fails, it should wear dark glasses and pretend to be blind. It should guide those who are safe into the middle of busy roads and leave them there. It should scatter woodworm into the bedrooms of all peg-legged men, not being afraid to hurt the innocent. It should shout, "Evil, evil, evil," from the roofs of stock exchanges. It should not pretend to be a clerk or a librarian. It is the eventual sameness of contradictions. It should never weep unless it is alone, and then only after it has covered the mirrors and sealed up the cracks. Poetry should seek out pale and lyrical couples and wander with them into stables, neglected bedrooms, engineless cars, unsafe forests, for a final good time. It should enter burning factories too late to save anybody. It should pay no attention to its name. Poetry should be seen lying by the side of road accidents, hissing from unlit gas rings. It should scrawl the nymph's secret on her teacher's blackboard, offer her a worm saying, "Inside this is a tiny apple." At dawn, it should leave the bedroom and catch the first bus home to its wife. At dusk, it should chat up a girl nobody wants. It should be seen standing on the ledge of a skyscraper, on a bridge with a brick tied around its heart. Poetry is the monster hiding in a child's dark room. It is the scar on a beautiful person's face. It is the last blade of grass being picked from the city park. The world's first junior executive. The world's first junior executive, now 87 years old, sits alone in his study, looking outside, where it seems buildings are collapsing on one another, and he, still alone these years on, draws up the final schedule, the final business transaction between man and God. This morning, the dawn hesitates over Woolworths, wondering whether to disturb his phallic dreams or let them go on. Birds of love that once flew in pairs now make singular journeys. He who was not brave about living is less brave about dying. Still, he dies. And in various offices, new executives rise, not in silent tribute, but to cough and apply for what his death has left open to them. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I am back in the bar in front of our beautiful waving cat because we have got lucky and we're able to open again soon. So there will be news about when Poetryspective can be back at the bar, and we hope that that's as soon as possible. It's been amazing online, and there may be additions that continue online, and that will be announced by Lish in due course, but it has been amazing online, and also can't wait to have you all back in the bar. I want to read a poem today called Out of Nowhere Digitally, and here it is. We are well into the digital age. Our cars do not yet fly, though verge on driving themselves. The grand temples of old have been replaced with digital temples dedicated to thyself. Often strangers will attempt to access one's digital temple with neither invitation nor clear motive. It is a virtual maneuver, virtually useless. But on a day recently, one of these intruders presented differently. A face so exquisite practically a biometric download of desire. The intruder, also well-spoken, well-educated and well-travelled, and allegedly well-interested. Now a train speeds the intruder to a meeting with cold reality, and the merits of the digital age will again be tested. Well, thank you very much for being here. We will see you next time.
Now, it's time for our second feature, Mr. Steve Smart. Steve has had a shit year. You probably have too. He's not fond of being off stage for long periods of time. But he has been working on a new full-length hour show and is ready to preview some of his new work with you, at you, for you. Steve has also been stockpiling new stage costume pieces and makeup. So expect weirdness to be afoot. Now, knowing Steve, I'm sure that he's being honest about the weirdness that you are about to witness. For those of you who don't know Smarty, he has been performing his poetry around Melbourne and Australia and international cities for over 2 decades. He's also been an event host, a not-for-profit president, a festival director, a TV extra, a theatre student, a collaborator and co-conspirator. Steve lives in Footscray, where all things are usually possible. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the new workings of Steve Smart.
Starts quiet. It always starts quiet. No one is sure why. So quiet. A whisper, so you can hear every noise the audience makes as they're settling into chairs, never quite as comfortable as you hope to feel. Spoiler, it's so you don't fall asleep during the quiet bits. It's very dimly lit, so you can imagine all kinds of fun surprises. Spoiler, it's a trick. There are no fun surprises coming. The press text fucking lied to you again. The press text is rarely to be trusted except at a Dave Hughes show, where you can be pretty confident of what you'll get, I imagine. I have never been to a Dave Hughes show. I probably shouldn't judge. Sorry, Dave Hughes. That whole last bit was in parentheses, just so you know. What we call an aside. Everything from spoiler to not judging Dave Hughes. Sorry, Dave Hughes. It starts quiet and dim, almost eerie, except that the person on stage keeps saying really stupid things about Dave Hughes, which lessens the effect of all this quiet dimness, don't you think? What the hell have you walked into? Why is it still so quiet and dim? Is there going to be some sort of loud noise or bright light soon to make you jump out of your chair in fright, mock fright, since you No, it's coming anyway. It always comes around about now. But no, we're not doing that. The light will stay much the same. The volume, it's not that sort of show. Don't you hate those sorts of shows? I fucking hate those sorts of shows. Once upon a time there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two. Remember how we laughed away the hours and think of all the great things we could do. Then the busy years went rushing by us. We lost our starry notions on the way. If by chance I'd see you in the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say, those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose, we'd fight and never lose. Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days. Just tonight I stood before the tavern. Nothing seemed to be the way it used to be. In the glass I saw a strange reflection. Was that lonely human really me? Through the door there came familiar laughter. I saw your face and heard you call my name. Oh, my friend, we're older but no wiser. For in our hearts the dreams are still the same. Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose, we'd fight and never lose. Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days. La 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 la. A child is born with a serious look, hands reaching for a pen to attempt to write a book before it can read. All signs point to a difficult life, years of solemn mind, fearful to look foolish. Something had to break when each day takes life so dreadfully dour as they, with little joy or time to play. What might destroy this straight face? One moment to redefine, to find disgrace, a pleasure, measuring no more each moment. In place of carefully sequenced notes comes something more clamorous. No more quoting Sophocles to please adults who should care less. This new blessing of reactiveness, restless spirit emerges, finds the world is not as imagined. The rich pageant of making bad decisions and pride in each one. What is the worst that could happen? So your shoes and jacket do not match. Hey, it might catch on, or just go barefoot. Some things are simply not as important as we allow ourselves to believe. So should we not relieve ourselves of care? Each day find reinvention as key. The child of serious look tries first a pout, a scowl, and then a smile. There's fun to be had in behaving badly. So embrace the performance. Revel in your inner glow stick. Glitter yourself up a bit. Oh, try to seem entertaining. Parody all you meant to be. Smile, look pretty. So you woke up in a bad mood. Who needs to know? You're on show now. Stage lights up. Cup half drunk. refill at will. No one needs to see the real you. They may not like you anyway, so play the lush. Add a touch of theatre to a better version than the cranky bitch you were when you twitched your way out of bed. At least pretend to be famous. Lend yourself a mask. Flash a little leg, but never beg for applause. Don't be desperate, dear. Speak clearly. Head up, chin out. A performer has to be able to take a punch. You've been doing this for long enough. Tougher than you look. Oh, we all hope to hell. Embrace the parody of all you meant to be. Be fun at parties. Regrets are for your own time. If you don't shine here, then where? If you don't shine now, then when? This is what you said you wanted, so look like you're not half dead. Glitter up. The show is about to begin, and if you do it right, they'll never know. What they're in for. This unspoken artifice is not supposed to reveal the mechanism. This isn't what is interesting to me. What I want to know is what you want. What I have to decide is whether to give it to you. How far out on a limb might I go? Do I walk the plank or does the plank walk me? Makes no sense, that. Planks don't walk themselves. A dog will walk itself, but will it walk itself home? Have you been kind to Fido? Hence the leash. Hence the leash. Repeat, turn away. Ponderous, but is he? Or is it a bit of business? Stage crafting a look. Would you, could you, can you tell what is hidden from view? Whirring gears, that mechanism earlier mentioned. If you could see what I can see. Eyes closed, mouth open. Oh, yes, if you could, or would, we might ask ourselves this one brief question. Who holds the leash to get us all home safe? I want you ugly, I want your disease. I want you everything as long as it's free. I want your love. Love, 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 I want your love. I want your drama, the touch of your hand. I want your leather studded kiss in the sand. I want your love. Love, 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 I want your love. You know that I want you. You know that I need you. I want it bad, your bad romance. I want your love and I want your revenge. You and me could write a bad romance. Oh, oh. I want your love and all your lovers' revenge. You and me could write a bad romance. Oh, 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 oh. Smile. Smile. Oh, hush, don't be so. Smile. Look behind you. Face, front, forward, march, and smile. You knew what you were getting into when you left the house. Expectations. Look alive. Look coy. Look like you mean it. But don't really mean it. Be the it. Slowly now. Turn, turn, turn. Shy, 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 shy. Bolder. Glow for me now. Smile. Smile until it feels like your face may turn to dust. We must have this moment. Hold, smile, hold, 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 smile. Hold, 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 smile, hold, cut. Stop rolling. Roll it out of here. Bring me the next, 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 next. You there. Stand straight. Turn. Face this way. Turn again. Stop. Now smile. Pathetic. Next, 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 next. Wait. Wait. You. Come over here and smile. Smile. I want your horror. I want your design. 'Cause you're a criminal as long as you're mine. I want your love. Love, 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 I want your love. I want your psycho, your vertigo shtick. Want you in my rear window, baby, you're sick. I want your love. love, 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 I want you. You know that I want you. You know that I need you. I got it bad. Your bad romance now. Or walk, walk, fashion, baby, work it, move it. That bitch crazy. Walk, walk, fashion, baby, work it, move it. That bitch crazy. Walk, walk, passion, baby, work it. I'm a free bitch, baby. Grotesquerie can be appealing. Lurid colors that clash with defiance. An off-key note played with gusto and repeated for the joy of it. The stumble and splat where delicate movement seems most called for. A hullabaloo in a quiet room. A guttural cry, a bold-faced lie told without expectation of belief. The smell of Katy Perry's purr. We expect harmony. Perfection to be at least attempted. Is there not relief at times at the lurching crash of beauty? A disturbance of the senses. Off kilter, an eyebrow not so much as raised as removed entirely and replaced with a common garden slug. You might wonder what kind of person finds this so entertaining. Might imagine you are not such a being. We like to think of our tastes as quite refined. The child we were that understood the beauty of otherness, put to bed forevermore. We don't like things that seem wrong, distasteful, antithetical to our senses. Ugly is to be avoided, is it not so? We all have wonderful taste, and yet our tastes are not the same. How to reconcile this dilemma, if beauty to me is ugliness to you? Ugliness. Such a more appealing word than beauty, don't you think? I think you do. But is it ugliness that bothers us, or difference, the unusual, unexpected? If I put my face just here, very close to yours, and I painted my lips in a... yellowish green like this, it would discomfort you, yes? And yet it might make me very happy indeed to do so. Should I apologize for this disturbance? If I took a song once popular and rousing to the senses, mutated it into something dark and festering like this. Like this. It might lead you to feel I am uncouth, mean-spirited even to tamper with a pleasant memory. The film of the year in whatever year it was when the ship went down. The ship went down. Many people died. The Titanic is steeped in horror, death, drunken incompetence. A story of the follies of humanity in believing any object to be beyond the laws of physics. Yet you render it a love story. Remember, pretty nude paintings. Meaningful glances between attractive actors, Celine Dion at full wail going on and on and on. Well, I cried, why the hell can't you aim Billy Zane? Kill him, Billy, oh, why can't you just fucking kill him? You see, we respond differently. Our experiences do not correlate. And I'd say I don't want to ruin the movie Titanic for you, but I do. Oh, how I've longed to all these years. You might not have liked Bikini Kill, and I might fucking love them. I might not be fond of Coldplay or any other band that sounds like Coldplay, but that may be your favorite music, and who am I to try to take that from you? Who am I to tell you what to like, and who are you to tell me either? Your idea of fashionable, my idea of individuality. Reverse. My idea of fashion, your idea of ugly, my idea of pretty, my idea of vomitous, your idea of reverse. I might like to take a 90s dance smash hit, turn it into something inherently awkward. It might sound something a little bit like this. I've got the key, I've got the secret,
I've got the key to another way. I've got to pee. I'm starting to regret. I didn't go before I walked on stage. Fucking hell.
I wanted to be unusual. Not like others. I wanted to challenge and change like Cindy or Stephanie Joanne, constantly evolving into something sharper. I wanted to get you out of your seat. They said poets can't do that. You can't dance to a poem. I wanted to sing. They said I should stick to poetry. Stay in your lane. Don't try to be different. People might not like you so well. Stay comfortable. Comforting. When you're on the edge of success, don't ruin the mood. Reinvention is everything, but all you ask for is the same. I get so bored with what other people think I am. That isn't what success looks like in my mind. This is what success looks like in my mind. All my performances are masks in progress. The performance says I need a mask to task myself with being make-believe. And then believing so hard it draws you in. So we exist in this moment as though in an altered truth. As I age, the line blurs. What first was honest expression becomes something less straightforward, best described as burlesque. Later you may wonder what was true, what was caricature, and I may need to feel that I may feel the need to tell you, but let's agree to not reveal. Let's agree that what feels honest might be, what feels like spite is born from there, what feels like lies might just be the rare moments I tell you the truth. This unspoken artifice is not supposed to reveal the mechanism. That isn't what is interesting to me. What I want to know is what you want. What I have to decide is whether to give it to you. Some things are simply not as important as we allow ourselves to believe, so should we not relieve ourselves of care? Each day find reinvention as key. The child of serious look tries first to pout, a scowl, and then a smile. There's fun to be had in behaving badly. Still, I feel the need to ask who holds the leash. How much of our speech, our beliefs, are evidence of free thinking? How much are we in control? Roll back the footage of our lives. Let's see how much we can agree that we have been the best that any of us could be.
I love you because I'm there. Hi, guys. Thanks so much for having me on your show. I have three poems, so I'll get right into it. The first is called A Disappointment. I offer you an awkward hug, a too polite caress. That's how things stand between us now, like happiness, but less. This second poem is called He Was Outraged, He Was Outraged. He was outraged. He was outraged at the outrage of the outrage. And he raged his outrage out. All his outrage at the outrage. And he shook it all about. And his outrage at the outrage of the outrage caused him doubt. And still more outrageous outrage. Till he shouted with a shout in his own face at himself. With an inward, outward pout. Calm down, you bloody bastard! And it didn't help a bit. And this last one is called Old clothes fit best, old clothes fit best, that mould to growing form, sit snug upon a slow expanding chest, fold neat on feet, relax on cushioned haunch, you rest when dressed, for dressed they are at rest. Give me a jumper, woolly in her ways, with subtle, supple stretches in her plaid, who takes me in her arms through all my days as one who has since birth been for her maid. Old clothes fit best. Say 10 days old or so to see you through a winter's week or two. Not urgent for detergent, clothes that glow each day with more perfection, good and true. And any smutch that dares to rest upon them should feel honoured such clothes should wish to don them. Thank you very much.
What a marvellous night we've had here at Poetryspective 54, the 7th online edition. Thank you to Colin Clark and Co. for the fabulous Adam Gibson retrospective tonight. I enjoyed that very much, and I'm sure that the audience did too. And of course, Steve Smart, your set was magical. I loved the costumes and the words, and I'm very much looking forward to your 1 hour show when you produce it. I will be there, front row, applauding so enthusiastically. Seriously. And thank you to the open section as well. We had words, we had music, we had it all. And it is very much appreciated, because without you guys submitting, our program would be quite a bit shorter. And our listeners. Of course, without you guys, who would we be performing for but ourselves? So, if you enjoyed tonight and past episodes, feel free to submit. You can do so in several ways, and all that information is on the Poetryspective page on Facebook. And you can also find us on Twitter and YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe here to the Poetryspective channel and like our videos. Check out some of the old episodes and features and things. There's some real gems in there. And of course, in a fortnight's time, we have two new features for you, but they are a surprise because they are so good. So keep an eye out for that as well. And so this is Lish signing off. Take your care and see you in a fortnight.